Have you ever gotten home from a session where you just had the best time shooting? It was magical and wonderful, and you cannot wait to get to the computer and upload those images. And then you get them uploaded, and it's so overwhelming. There are too many to choose from. It's a lot of editing, and you know it's going to take you so much time to get narrowed down to the amount of images you had promised to your client. Maybe you promised them 25, and you've got at least 100 keepers. So how can we combat that? I use a system called Softproofing where I show my clients their images before they've been fully edited. I'll get down to that maybe 100-ish number of images and do a quick edit in Lightroom and then upload them to my gallery software, Pictime. I absolutely love Pictime for its beauty and its ease of use for my clients, plus its versatility. And I want to show you today how my clients go about selecting their images and then showing them to me. Let's get into it. All right, so I want to show you what this looks like in Pictime. I have opened one of the galleries that I've already completed, so you can see the full process here. I'm going to go to Photos, and you can see that I have their proofs here. So you would upload by clicking the little plus sign. I label that album as or as scene as proofs, and I upload all of the proofed images there for them. So when they get their proofing gallery, this is what they're going to see. There's all of the images, and then there's a header here that says proofs. They'll go through then and choose the flag on the images. There's not a flag option at the moment because this does not have an open selection. You could also choose to have them favorite images, but I feel like having them use the selection tool, which I'm going to get into and show you, is a much clearer way to know that you're both on the same page. So I send them this proofing gallery, which had, I think, close to 100 images, and they have to narrow it down to the ones they want to keep. It is easy for a parent to look at this photo versus this photo and see which one they prefer of themselves or of their baby. Whereas for me, it's a little trickier to decide what they're going to like. I'm just going to scroll through these so you can see that this was a session with a lot of variety, and it was really hard for me to pick. Here you can see how these are not final images. These have a light edit on them. The backgrounds aren't fixed. None of the like skin smoothing is done. No sharpening, no fixing any little things on the images. These have a global edit that is quick and easy for me to do. I have a preset. Especially with studio work, this is really simple because you're in a controlled environment. You can use the same preset from previous sessions or whatever. You kind of have a nailed down style when you're doing studio work. Oh, this one kills me because I definitely screwed that up and it's going to be hard to edit. But I included it still in case that was the one they really loved. Just so you get an idea of what a proofing gallery looks like, it's a huge gallery. So when the client gets this gallery, they're going to have little flags on all of the images. I'm going to go back to Pictime. So once I've uploaded the proofs, I'm going to come into gallery setup. I would turn off the online store. I would turn off clients can download photos, turn off sharing, turn off that clients can add photos. I always request the email before entering the gallery so I know who's looking at what photos. I would typically put a watermark on a proofing gallery just as a layer of protection for myself. I also have my own email packages now. I just have it labeled as mine, but I was able to save my template emails into Pictime so I don't have to rewrite those every time. Once that's done, you would go to share. You're going to type in the client's name and email, but you're not going to send that to the client by clicking this button just yet. You just want to put it in there. Once you've done that, this workflow button will appear as an option. So here is where you're going to go to client selections. You'll click plus here. You'll put in the selection name. I put proofs usually, and I put the amount as however many images are in the gallery, so they can choose up to every image if they wanted to pay for every image. You can require a certain amount of images. That's a lower amount than what's in the gallery. Say you wanted them to choose 25 exactly, you could put 25 here. It will have their name here in the send to already. And since I've chosen it to be my email package, that email is already there. It gives them exact instructions. It tells them that the images in their proofing gallery have not been retouched, explains what that means, and then it tells them how to place their order. To place your order, mark the images you'd like to purchase with flags. You can click the flag on the upper right corner of the screen to see all of your chosen images. When you are happy with your selection, you can click Send to Photographer, and I will be notified which of the images you'd like retouched for your final purchase. It tells them the timeline for delivery and makes sure that they know exactly what the process is, and gives them a button to flag photos. Once your client has clicked that they're done flagging photos, you'll get an email and you'll get this selection completed option here. So here you can see which images they chose. What I love and what makes it so easy for me is that I can then click this three-dot button and click CVS list, copy for Lightroom, and then I can paste that list of file numbers directly into the Lightroom catalog and it will pull up the images that I need to edit. I then hit flag for all of those images and I know what I need to edit for that client, and it makes it super easy. As you could see previously back in the photos here, I put the proofs in the same album as the final images so that it keeps it organized for me and that I don't have to then delete proofs from any gallery. I have an unlimited plan with Pictime, so I'm not super concerned about storage limits. Then when I put the final images in, I go ahead and hide from all the proof images. So that gives you an idea of how I use Pictime for client selection. And you can see then that there are their final images. Much easier than trying to narrow it down myself. They ended up choosing 25 photos and I delivered 5 of those images in black and white as well. Hope that is helpful. I'm Kate with DEARKATE Brand Strategy. I would love to talk to you more about softproofing or Pictime, any of these things. Leave a comment below and I will be happy to answer any questions.